students, welcome to the lecture on Introduction to International Business. And after this lecture, we will be able to learn the following objectives. Explain the international business, describe international strategic choices, understand the nature, scope and need for international business, understand the importance of international business. Let's start with an introduction to international business. International business is a word that is used to cooperatively explain all profitable deals, confidential and governmental, trades, assets, logistics and transport that take place among two or more regions, countries and nations outside their political periphery. Regularly, private companies start such transactions for profits, governments undertake them for profit and for political reasons. It refers to all those business activities which involve cross-border transactions of goods, services, resources between two or more nations. Transaction of economic resources contain money, skills, people and so on for worldwide production of physical goods and services such as finance, banking, insurance, construction and so on. The simplest definition for international business is cross-border or economic activity. This has existed in various forms ever since human communities began interacting with one another. When human tribes first started trading beads or minerals like flint, more than 10,000 years ago, they were engaging in prehistoric forms of international business. Of course, trade has become slightly more complicated since then. Nowadays, international business refers to the exchange not only of physical goods, but also of services, capital, technology, and human resources. We look at how firms can increase their profitability by expanding their operations in foreign markets. We discuss the different strategies that firms pursue when competing internationally, consider the pros and cons of these strategies, discuss the various factors that affect a firm's choice of strategy, and look at the tactics firms adopt when competing head-to-head across various national markets. Let us now discuss the international business. International business conducts business transactions all over the world. These transactions include the transfer of goods, services, technology, managerial knowledge, and capital to other countries. International business involves exports and imports.
Business activities and really have a firm grasp on international business going forward. So first off though, let's really identify what we mean by business. I know many of you understand what this concept is. Many of you engage in business activities every single day, but really let's define it and make sure everyone's on the same page. So a business, we often call it an enterprise or a firm. It's whenever an organization of some sort engages in a trade of goods or services or both to consumers. To really make it simple, think about your own lemonade stand that you had when you were a six-year-old, right? That was a business. You were operating a business. You sold lemonade, which was a good, to prospective customers, and they would in turn provide you with some sort of currency, something of value, most likely money. Many of you probably tried selling lemonade at $10 a pop and failed at operating your own business. But whether or not you failed, you still engaged in a business. And most businesses engage in what you tried, profit, right? Most businesses try and acquire profit. And so they sell their goods or services above what it costs them to produce. However, many businesses also operate as non-profit entities. And therefore, they sell their goods or services at a level that just covers the costs of operating their business. So whether or not you engage in business such as Walmart or you are Goodwill, you are both businesses. So what makes a business an international business? Well, it's very, very simple. As soon as a business, an organization, engages in business activity across regions or country or political borders, they all of a sudden have become an international business. Many private and governmental businesses are international. Any sales business, international. They'll sell their goods across borders. Investments take place over borders, right? Logistics, traveling or getting goods and services and resources to and from businesses, again, across borders. And transportation, again, often takes the form traveling across borders. And so as soon as that happens, businesses all of a sudden become international businesses. Very, very simple. So let's take a look at it from another perspective and really differentiate it from a domestic business. The traditional business model was domestic businesses. These were businesses that operated within a country's borders. For Canada, we saw domestic businesses thrive over the last hundred years, right? These businesses sold their goods and services to Canadian customers. They would purchase their resources from other Canadian companies that operated within the country's borders, right? And they would make investments to various organizations within the country's borders as well. So these were domestic businesses, and therefore they operated in a domestic market. So how does a business become an international business? Well, as mentioned, as soon as that money, as soon as that transaction takes place across a country's borders, well, all of a sudden it becomes an international business. So if a Canadian retailer starts selling their goods and services to, I don't know, someone in Australia, then it's an international business. As soon as a Canadian company purchases resources from, let's say, a company in Russia, then it's an international business. Or if a company in Canada invests in a business, let's say in Brazil, again, it becomes an international business. So what makes a business an international business? Well, here are some examples. Imagine a Canadian retailer opens a store in another country. Or maybe a U.S. retailer, I don't know, Le Target, let's say, opens a store in Canada. It's a international business. What if a business operates a manufacturing plant overseas? I mean, many Canadian companies do this and operate manufacturing plants oftentimes in places like China. What if you export your products to foreign countries, right? That's an international business, or import products from a foreign business. I mean, look in your wardrobe. How many of you have t-shirts or jeans made in Canada? I would say probably, zero. That's how many of you would probably have jeans or t-shirts made in Canada, right? You've engaged in international business, or have purchased from a business, I should say, that is an international business. And the last one, investing. Many businesses invest in other businesses, in other organizations, right? And these investments travel across borders and therefore become international businesses.
International business is also known or called or referred to as a global business or an international marketing. An international business has many options for doing business. It includes exporting goods and services, giving license to produce goods in the host country, starting a joint venture with the company, opening a branch for producing and distributing goods in the host country, providing managerial services to companies in the host country. Features of international business. The nature and characteristics of features of international business are large-scale operations. In international business, all the operations are conducted on a very huge scale. Production and marketing activities are conducted on a large scale. It first sells its goods in the local market, then the surplus goods are exported. The integration of economies. International business integrates or it combines the economies of many countries. This is because it uses finance from one country, labor from another country, and infrastructure from another country. Dominated by developed countries and MNCs. International business is dominated by developed countries and their multinational corporations, MNCs. At present, MNCs from USA, Europe, and Japan dominate or fully control the foreign trade. Benefits of participating countries. International business gives benefits to all participating countries. However, the developed or the rich countries get the maximum benefits. The developing or the poor countries also get benefits. Keen competition. International business has to face keen or too much competition in the world market. The special role of science and technology. International business gives a lot of importance to science and technology. The international restrictions. International business faces many restrictions on the inflow and the outflow of capital, technology, and goods. Sensitive nature. The international business is very sensitive in nature. Global business. Global business consists of transactions that are devised and carried out across national borders to satisfy the objectives of individuals, the companies, and the organizations. These transactions take on various forms, which are often interrelated. The primary types of international business are import-export trade and foreign direct investment, FDI. The latter is carried out in varied forms, including wholly owned subsidiaries and joint ventures. Additional types of international business are licensing, franchising, and management contracts. Environmental factors of international business. Environmental factors for international business comprise the external relations a firm will face in going global. These include, most importantly, the economic, political, and legal environments, each of these always entangled with the others. The basic issues. The central issues for the decision to go global are concerned with minimizing risk. A company, when considering the environment that it will deal with when entering a new market, has to deal with certain variables. The economic environment. This element comprises the nature of the economic system and the institutions of a particular country or a region. It also takes into account the nature of the human and natural resources within the target market. The political environment. Closely tied to the economic environment is the political one. It itself also dealing with the nature of systems and institutions. Many variables to consider here are the stability of the political system, the existence of local or international conflict, the role of state enterprise, and the nature of the bureaucracy. The reasons and benefits why organizations want to internationalize their business. Nowadays, there are many organizations which want to increase their business abroad. Companies go international for a variety of reasons, but typically they want company growth or expansion. In this blog post, we will find out some of these things and also we will think some benefits that organizations can reach by the act of making something international. Usually reasons for internationalizing are growth, employees, resources and ideas. Many companies are looking international markets for getting growth because they want to expand their business. Probably the most important reason to internationalize business is that often company can hire cheaper employees. Some companies go international to locate resources that are difficult to have in their home markets. Also, companies go international if they want to extend their workforce and they have new ideas. A component of a global business plan. A global business plan is essentially for any company looking to expand into the international marketplace. The components of a business plan create an intricate study of regional economic conditions, demand in the global market, and how the company may best enter each market for maximum success. A well-researched and executed global business plan can be the edge that makes a business truly successful on foreign soil. Market study. A detailed description of the international marketplace is a key component in any company's global business plan. This is a study analyzing existing competition and demand in the markets the business is looking to enter and shows how the business can best position its products and services within the context of those markets. Operation plans. The operations component of the global business plan should include elements related to how the company plans to create its products, manufacturing locations, retail outlets, and distribution lines. Now, moving on to the next topic, we will study the international strategic choices. Strategic choice is the third logical element of the strategy formulation process. Choice is at the center of strategy formulation. If there are no choices to be made, there can be little value in thinking about strategy at all. On the other hand, there will always, in practice, be limits on the range of possible choices. In general, small enterprises tend to be limited by the resources, whereas large enterprises find it difficult to change quickly and so tend to be constrained by their past. In a tidy logical world, any process of choice could be rationally divided into four steps: identify options, evaluate the options against preference criteria, select the best option, and then take action. This suggests that identifying and choosing options can be done purely analytically. In practice, it may be difficult to identify all possible options with equal clarity or at the same time. Unexpected events can create new opportunities or destroy foreseen opportunities, or they can alter the balance of the advantage between the two opportunities. Identifying and evaluating options is a useful approach, but it has limitations. It is necessary to remember that the future may evolve differently from the options. Since strategic choice tends to be so fuzzy, it is useful to define the words being used. We shall adopt the following definitions. Choice and strategic choice refer to the process of selecting one option for implementation. An option is a course of action that it appears possibly to take. The simplest form of choice is therefore between taking an option and not taking it, doing it or not doing it. Most choices have more shades of possibility than this. International strategy. Firms that pursue an international strategy try to create value by transferring valuable skills and products to foreign markets where indigenous competitors lack those skills and products. Most international firms have created value by transferring differentiated product offerings developed at home to new markets overseas. An international strategy makes sense if a firm has a valuable core competence that indigenous competitors in foreign markets lack, and if the firm faces relatively weak pressures for local responsiveness and cost reductions. A multi-domestic strategy. Firms pursuing a multi domestic strategy orient themselves towards achieving maximum local responsiveness. Multi-domestic firms extensively customize both their product offering and their marketing strategy to match different national conditions. They also tend to establish a complete set of value creation activities, including production, marketing, and R&D in each major national market in which they do business. The global strategy. Firms that pursue a global strategy focus on increasing profitability by reaping the cost reductions that come from experience curve effects and location economies. The production, marketing, and R&D activities of firms pursuing a global strategy are concentrated in a few favorable locations. Global firms tend not to customize their product offering and marketing strategy to local conditions because customization raises costs. Transnational strategy. Christopher Barlett and Sumantra Ghoshal have argued that in today's environment, competitive conditions are so intense that to survive in the global marketplace, firms must exploit experience-based cost economies and location economies. They must transfer core competency within the firm, and they must do all this while paying attention to pressures for local responsiveness. The structure of strategic choice. In practice, the process for choosing a strategy may be structured something like, although the reality is likely to be much messier. The process of choice starts by identifying available options. The chosen strategy will have to answer the questions what, how, why, who, and when, so each option will provide provisional answers to each of these questions. Let's know the nature, scope, and need for international business. International business is the process of focusing on the resources of the globe and objectives of the organization on global business opportunities and threats. International business, defined as global trade of goods and services or investment, more comprehensive view does not focus on the firm but on the exchange process. Free trade occurs when a government does not attempt to influence through quotas or duties what its citizens can buy from another country or what they can produce and sell to another country. The nature of international business. It's accurate information. Information not only accurate but should be timely. The size of the international business should be large. The market segmentation based on geographic segmentation. The scope of international business. The term international business was not popular 2 decades earlier. The term international business has emerged from the term international marketing, which in turn emerged from the term international trade. International trade, international marketing. Originally, the producers used to export their products to the nearby countries and gradually extended the exports to far-off countries. Gradually, the companies extended the operations beyond trade. International marketing to international business. The multinational companies which were producing the products in their home countries and marketing them in various foreign countries before 1980s started locating their plants and other manufacturing facilities in foreign or host countries. Later, they started producing in one foreign country and marketing in other foreign countries. Problems in international business. The political factors, the high foreign investments and high cost, the exchange instability, the entry requirements. Complexities involved in international business. International business is multinational, so the complexities are also related to their working. Some of these complexities are controlling the market. Multinational corporation trying to control the market of the host country. Whenever they enter a new country, the first strategy is to eliminate the competitors either by taking over the business or forcing them out of market by following price reduction policies. Exhausting the natural resources. Multinational corporations set up their production facilities in those countries where the natural resources are available in sufficient quantities. The points that highlight the importance of international business are to earn foreign exchange. International business exports its goods and services all over the world. This helps to earn valuable foreign exchange. This foreign exchange is used to pay for imports. Foreign exchange helps to make the business more profitable and to strengthen the economy of its country. Optimum utilization of resources. International business makes optimum utilization of the resources. This is because it produces goods on a very large scale for the international market. International business utilizes resources from all over the world. It uses the finance and the technology of rich countries and the raw materials and labor of the poor countries. Achieve its objectives. International business achieves its objectives easily and quickly. The main objective of an international business is to earn high profits. This objective is achieved easily. This is because it uses the best technology. It has the best employees and managers. It produces high quality goods. It sells these goods all over the world. All results to high profits for the international business. To spread business risks. International business spreads its business risk. This is because it does business all over the world. So a loss in one country can be balanced by a profit in another country. The surplus goods in one country can be exported to another country. The surplus resources can also be transferred to other countries. All this helps to minimize the business risk. Improve organization's efficiency. International business has very high organization efficiency. This is because without efficiency, they will not be able to face the competition in the international market. So, they use all of the modern management techniques to improve their efficiency. They hire the most qualified and the most experienced employees and managers. These people are trained regularly. They are highly motivated with very high salaries and other benefits such as international transfers, promotions, and so on. All this results in high organization efficiency, that is low cost and high returns. They get benefits from government. International business brings a lot of foreign exchange for the country. Therefore, it gets many benefits, facilities and concessions from the government. It gets many financial and tax benefits from the government. It expands and diversifies. International business can expand and diversify into its activities. This is because it earns very high profits. It also gets financial help from the government. Increase in competitive capacity. International business produces high quality goods at low cost. It spends a lot of money on advertising all over the world. It uses superior technology, management techniques, marketing techniques, and so on. All this makes it more competitive, so it can fight competition from foreign companies. Now, in the end, let us summarize what we have learned in this lecture. International business is the process of focusing on the resources of the globe and objectives of the organization on global business opportunities and threats. International business is dominated by developed countries and multinational corporations, MNCs. A transnational strategy makes sense when a firm faces high pressures for cost reductions and high pressures for local responsiveness. Global business consists of transactions that are devised and carried out across national borders to satisfy the objectives of individuals, companies, and organizations. An international strategy makes sense if a firm has a valuable core competence that indigenous competitors in foreign markets lack, and if the firm faces relatively weak pressures from local responsiveness and cost reductions. International business is important and necessary because economic isolationism it has become impossible. A global business plan is essential for any company looking to expand into the international marketplace.